So as you know, AI is everywhere, but recently I found out about Evoto, which is an app that does retouching. It's a huge time saver, and to be honest, I'm really surprised by how powerful it is. But once I started playing around, I realized I need to share this with you guys because I'm surprised by how well it works and what a potential huge time saver it could be. Check it out. So the first thing you do is you bring your images in, just hit the plus button, and then you can bring them in. They appear in there. Now, at this point, we could go full manual if you wanted and just use the adjustments and all the tools you would expect to hear. But we're not going to focus on those in this tutorial. We're going to look at the cool AI stuff. So it comes with a bunch of presets. You could just click on the presets and, as you can see, different looks or whatever you want. We can go with cinematic looks, film looks, or just go for some basic retouching. So what I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to reset this. So we just click up here and reset all effects. So let's have a look at some of the tools that are available. Some of the ones that really stand out to me are things like glass glare reduction. So, you know, we get glare on glasses. If we go under the face, we go up under eyes, glass glare, and just increase that. Boom, it's gone. Another thing I know people struggle with is braces. So if we turn on the pretty teeth, it will remove the braces just like that. Now, be aware of this because it can actually change the teeth. So if we look, say, for example, this image here and we turn on the teeth, it will actually build a whole new set of teeth. So be careful, you know, that your client actually wants that before applying it. So things like wrinkly clothes, you know, we click on the clothing here, we can de-wrinkle. And we can go all the way up and it's freshly ironed. Look at that. It's pretty amazing. And see, as we're selecting it, under the retouching, it's giving us the set. It's noticing it's a female. But if we are selecting like a male, it shows a male. And this will give us things like beard protection and different things like that. And so what's interesting is if we have a couple in here and we click on female here. So she's got a little bit of a shine. Let's reduce the shine. Notice it just removes it on the woman and not the man. So if we choose the male, and maybe we want to get rid of the face shine on there. We do that. Notice it adjusts just on the man and not the woman. So it's pretty smart. Let's look at some of the settings. So we want to reduce the acne. We can just turn that on and look at that. Just like magic, it disappears. You can go very far. You can go just a little bit. And if you so want, you can adjust acne or freckles. So a lot of the time you might remove the acne, but leave the freckles in place, and you could just pull that down if you wanted to do that. Another interesting thing with this setting actually that I found is it can actually, if we look here, he's got a little bit of a 5 o'clock shadow. Watch this. We can literally give him a little bit of a shave. It's pretty crazy. That's just kind of a bonus there. So another problem we can have is kind of the shine on the face, and we can reduce this just by simply dragging it here. Why don't we zoom in and look at some of these settings a little bit more in depth? So if we have the forehead wrinkle, we can reduce that. Now, I wouldn't completely remove any of these unless your client specifically asks for that. So a more subtle retouch is going to look more natural. And if you wanted to smoothen out some of the irregularities, retouches generally dodge and burn, but we can do the equivalent here. See how that'll just kind of smoothen that out. Now you could do the skin smoothing here if you wanted, which would kind of give you a frequency separation look. I'm going to keep that quite low though. And we can also adjust the texture of the skin. So we could go for a matte. We could go for a satin look, or we could go for a dewy look. I think on this particular one, we're going to go for a dewy, but we're going to bring down the glossiness a little bit. So if you wanted, you could unify the complexion. Maybe if you're going for more of a high-end beauty retouch kind of a look. So we can also give it a little bit of radiance to the skin. And rosy complexion, this will actually put a little bit of red. Let me put this up high so you can see. See how that'll put a little red into her. So let's be careful that we don't go too far with that. And then stuff that I don't really do in my work is facial and body reshaping. But if that's a request, you can do all that too. Now we can go in the eyes, we can change the brightness. Now be wary, you don't want to go too far with that. See how it gets a little crazy. So just give it just a little touch here. And if we look, we see some of the reds in the eye there. We can remove that by using red veins. Look at that. We can just reduce those or remove them completely. And in this case, I have catch lights in here, but if you didn't have catch lights, you could literally go in here and add all kinds of catch lights. And you can adjust them. You've got all kinds of adjustments there. We don't need them because we already have them. Now let me zoom out a little bit because we had a lot of stray hairs here. If you've spent a lot of time fixing those, we just go under here and we can just remove stray hairs. Watch this. Boom, done. And of course you can adjust how much you want to do that. And if you want to see where we're at, here's our before and here's our after. Just by tapping here. And another interesting thing, we even have the ability to do makeup. So if we turn on here and we go down, there's a bunch of presets. So you could try some different makeup presets and this will literally apply makeup on our model. Maybe sweet. And we can adjust the amount. So if you want to be a lot more subtle with that, we can just give it just a little touch. And while you're in here, you have the ability to change pretty much everything. So if we go in here, I mean, if you want to do contouring, you could do this. Want to do the Kim Kardashian thing? That's all available. And then we have other things, you know, like lashes. You know, you can even add false eyelashes if you want. Once you've applied this, if you want, you could save it as a preset. And we'll call this test C for Callan, who's the model, and hit save. So now I have my own presets that I've created. So if say we were going to do this and we're just going to completely reset all effects, there we go. We could apply the preset we just created. And so the other thing that's kind of cool is, you know, we've got another picture of her. Say we want to sync these settings. I can take this one and then just hold the shift key, click the one I want to sync it to, and then just choose sync. And if we look at the second image, boom, there it is synced before. After. All right, so here's a huge time saver. So say we've got other photos from this set. Let me just scroll past. We've got some more here. So I'm going to hit Control on Windows, Command on Mac, and then we're just going to select some other images, maybe these other four, and we want to sync it. So we're just going to choose sync. So you only have to make the adjustments once, and then you can sync it very quickly to all the other images. So if you're doing things like portrait shoots or weddings or group photos, you can sync it up and just save a whole ton of time. Now, generally in a wedding, you would be doing much more subtle retouching. Let's have a look and see where we've got. So if we have this and we look at it there, before, after, just done in one click. Before, after, boom. Very, very quick and easy to sync these up. So another thing that I like about this is we can do the background. So if we click here, we have the background adjustments. So you can actually import your own backdrops or we can use the ones they have here. Let's have a look at maybe the fabric. Look at that. In one click, we can just change the backdrop. So we could go, you know, just for a solid color. Texture, or we've got more, we can click on more and you'll see there's a whole bunch of different types of backdrops that we could use here. Now the way the pricing works is it's free to download and install, and you can experiment, you can make adjustments to all these different images, and then what you actually do is you pay for what you use. And how that works is when you choose to export. And this is where you would pay to export an image, and we click export, and that will actually use up one of your credits. If you look in the description, there's a link that you can use that will give you 30 free export credits. So you can go ahead, use this, and export up to 30 images for free. So as you can see, we just barely scratched the surface of what this application is able to do. One of the things that really impressed me about it, though, is the clean interface and how quick and snappy it works. Everything here that you saw was happening in real time. I didn't speed any of this up. So I'm curious what your guys' thoughts are. Let me know in the comments underneath. If you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.